Middle of the Big East. Mountaineers number one undefeated in conference play, and a good start at staying that way. Up 14-3 as we start the second quarter. UConn ball, their 18. And the freshman Dennis Brown. Short yardage, if any. Maybe one for Brandon McLean on his 10th catch of the year, knocked backwards by Anthony Mims. Headed down to 40 degrees tonight in Morgantown. UConn and West Virginia, just their second meeting ever. Dave Barnett, Craig James, Holly Rowe. And the first career road start, second collegiate appearance for Brown. The third starting quarterback. And an injury-plagued position for Randy Edsall and Norris Wilson, his offensive coordinator, with Matt Bonislawski, who started the first five games, out with a collarbone fracture. DJ Hernandez out with a wrist injury. And Brown down.
I do believe that Dennis Brown's going to throw the ball down the field a little bit more.
Another short kick by Shane Hussar. And Vaughn Rivers returns it to the 35. And here, after just a 30-yard punt, is a chance to take, if they don't already have it, real, total control of this game.
And you see the coaching and the scouting. Recognizing that Connecticut doesn't kick it deep, you put three guys back, so you cover two different levels of punts, and it pays off. The ball doesn't hit the carpet. It doesn't roll for 15 or 20 yards.
UConn now minus 13 on the ground. No support for their freshman quarterback. Brown is 5 of 9, 49 through the air. Just the reverse for West Virginia. Back to Slayton on first down. They have rushed for 95, and their redshirt freshman starting quarterback, Pat White, has thrown for a total of 8 through the air on 2 out of 7. 9 carries, 42 yards and a score for Slayton. Adam Bednarik said when he got his shot tonight, we do expect to see him at some point in the two-quarterback shuttle for West Virginia. Hope to be about 85% and then let the adrenaline take over with a sprained foot nagging in since the Louisville game. Swing pass to Schmidt. Turns that helmet forward, runs right over Tyvon Branch for the Mountaineer first.
And you can hear the hit from up top. Just get to the flat and an option for the quarterback. And nice execution, throwing the ball outside by Pat White, and then go get him. I mean, you see him leap.
I hope they've got lots of spare face masks.
That guy must have a forehead made of steel.
When you hear that as high up and as far back as we are up here, that's punishment. Slayton to the 20. Pickup of about 3 on first down.
And Slayton will watch the film tomorrow, and he'll wish that he stayed outside on this one. And recognize there's a lot of room beyond those hash marks. And with the speed that he has, as he gets older and more wise with the field, yeah, that's a big play.
Second and 7. UConn 20-yard line. And the catch by Myles, who turns it up straight up the field. Touchdown, West Virginia. Brandon Myles, the senior, with his third scoring catch of the year.
Well, you see the execution of the blocking and the throwing, the quick arm, getting it out to the outside for Myles, and just splits the defense. And right now, the Connecticut defense has put so much focus on stopping Slayton, and you have to, that it really opens up other opportunities.
McAfee to make it 21-3. West Virginia, credit Garen Justice for the block that sprung Brandon Myles. Untouched, West Virginia dominant early in the second. Well, we expected at some point to see DJ Hernandez, who was the second of the three starting quarterbacks used by UConn, and despite a fracture and a pin in his left wrist after being injured against Cincinnati, he seems to be ready to come in, although I don't put what's happened so far on Dennis Brown at all. He's done decently in the air, and he's got no support from the running game.
And I think at this point here, if you're Connecticut, you have to consider throwing the ball down the field and, again, going back and taking some chances. And it's not Dennis Brown. It's up front. It's the offensive line. it's the whole system right now that's got to pick it up. And maybe putting in Hernandez might give him a little bit of a change of pace, though. Who knows?
High short kick from the 13. And for 49 yards, the running game is minus 13. With problems just like that one. See if they say this was caused by the ground. No. Fumble recovered by Warren Young. Backup defensive tackle for the Mountaineers.
If there's a disappointing aspect of the game so far for me, it's the fact that Brockington and Cauley are two very seasoned, established, successful runners, and neither one of them have made a play. You know, when you come back and you look at it, I mean, it's almost the traction. Cutting on the inside foot, ball comes out, hand hits it.
Cornell Brockington has not had very many touches tonight. Had that one punched out, might not get very many more. After turning it over to West Virginia on their own 20, already down 18. Almost 12 minutes still in the first half. As Slayton reverses field, here's his speed on display.
Ooh.
From nowhere, gets a block. And turns what might have been a loss of five into a gain of three. And who threw it? His quarterback, Pat White. The block of the year, maybe, for West Virginia.
Did you hear the fans, the stands?
Well, Slayton's got speed, and he tries to get to the outside, but Connecticut flew out, pushed him, and he comes back. Now watch on the bottom middle of your screen. Quarterback, oh, man, laying the wood, Pat White. They just saw it on the replay.
They enjoyed it all over again. All that for gain of three, and inside it's Schmidt. Inside the 15. Definitely worth another look.
And, you know, there's one guy right now, competitively speaking, that wants a shot to go do something. Now, that would be Adam Bednarik. He wants to come out and do some of that himself as a backup quarterback. Man, that's how you get the fans and your teammates' ultimate respect, by playing hard. Hey, Holly, that's called flipping the switch right there.
Third and four. From the 14-yard line. White forced to scramble. Chased by Randall Fuller. He will turn it up the field and score. The first Mountaineer scoring drive, all Steve Slayton. This one, all Pat White.
It all started because of a fumble by Connecticut. And Pat White took full advantage of it, set the tempo and the tone with his block, and then with his legs.
Bednarik, just a sophomore, so they're going to have both these Mountaineer quarterbacks for the next 2 years. Another Pat McAfee point, 10:28 second quarter, another West Virginia touchdown, 28-3. Rust. Wow, what a first half by West Virginia, capitalizing on a couple of UConn errors. Pat White blocking and running on that drive to make it 28-3.
Well, you know, maybe it's a new idea and a concept. Maybe West Virginia schedules every 18 days.
Longest break they have had since 1908. And UConn continues to cause most of its own problems as Jimmy McClam shows some self-tackleization back at the 10.
If that's a word, Mr. North Texas.
Hey, Daryl Royal invented that term. That is a word.
Well, you know what? Once the quarterback, Pat White, breaks containment, look at all the yellow, the blue jerseys turn around and start blocking. And number 10 up top that I'd circled, Taylor, he too slipped. So maybe UConn's got the wrong cleat for this surface. I don't know. There's been a lot of slipping. Brockington slips. Cauley slips.
Taylor looking like he's ready to come back. this point, UConn just got to concentrate on getting a first down and hang it onto the ball. And they get both here from Terry Cauley, who was leading the nation in rushing when he was injured middle of the 2003 season. He missed the rest of that year, all of last year, rehabbing a knee that had two of its four ligaments shredded.
And you know what? You saw a different kind of play. Tackle to tackle, the dancing, and they can't outrun West Virginia's defense to the perimeter. Get down the hill, break some arm tackles.
From the 32, Brown, right into the hands of Anthony Mims. The corner returns it near the 10-yard line. And really, the first mistake you can definitely pin on Dennis Brown. He's had no support in the running game, but this is on him.
And you know what? Or if maybe a wide receiver was supposed to have hooked up on the outside as well. But the bottom line is, it's a miscommunication.
It's time they took it over, not quite this close. They have it 14 yards away from a 35-3 lead. Slayton stuffed on first down. Now tonight where UConn could afford to turn it over, as they have twice deep in their own end.
And I think last year the game where West Virginia visited out in Connecticut, and Connecticut played a spirited game and challenged them early, West Virginia was ready to play. You know, national television, Wednesday night, 18-day layoff. This team came out and they're playing up to their talent level.
No gain on first down. Dwight rolling, keeping, scored the last one with his legs and gets this one too.
Really nice execution on the quarterback's part. White gets to the outside and the receivers were covered up. They were covered, and White did what he's supposed to do, run. Spread them out, give yourself a chance to throw it in the end zone, then take off.
18 and a half minutes in the books. That's all it takes for the Mountaineers to build a 35-3 lead.
This game, so I don't know. It'll be interesting.
McClan, who slipped on his own 10 last time. Much better effort here. And out across the 25. Down to Holly.
17. Well, guys, Rich Rodriguez has had some different kinds of quarterbacks in his patented spread offense. But he says that Pat White is the best combination. He said, you know, Sean King at Tulane back in the late 90s had a great arm, but wasn't that great of a runner. Woody Dantzler at Clemson, so good with his legs, but not a pinpoint passer. He said Pat White is the best combination of those guys. He has the passing skills. He can put it where it needs to be, but he also can get it done with his legs. After all, he was an outfielder that got drafted by the Angels. Guys, he is the perfect combination for this spread offense of Rich Rodriguez.
He's got consecutive 14-yard touchdown runs. And Cauley tries to bounce this one outside. Strung out by the West Virginia defense, and he still gets about 3 yards out of it. Lorello chased him down. Cauley still experiences some fatigue in that knee that he injured 2 years ago, and the coaches say it's up to him to let them know when he's got to have some rest. And keep that constantly at the top of his mind, and to know that he's got a more than capable backup in Brockington.
Yeah, it's hard to call Cornell Brockington a backup with the success he's had in his career, but neither one of them tonight did anything done.
Brockington, first team All Big East last year. Anybody would like him as a backup. Anytime he carries it, Husky fans have got to have some pride in what he's done. Brown sacked for a loss back at the 25. West Virginia's not smelling blood.
Well, and I think what you're seeing, too, is two different levels of football. You know, West Virginia is really good. I've got them as an AP voter, number 12 in the country. I think they're a really good team. And so they're overpowering. They're overwhelming Connecticut right now. And I'm not surprised coming in this game. I think with a young quarterback starting on the road for the first time, we expected this. But You're seeing very nice execution right now.
Jeff Noschel, third sack of the night for West Virginia. Another very short punt by Husar. Just 25 yards, are getting shorter as the night wears on. And as it wears on, Pat White looks better and better.
Well, he has had a very interesting night here on a Wednesday night, and his legs and running the football has been quite impressive. The ability to throw the ball is there, but I thought that the run right here followed up with that big block he had. Remember that, Dave? When,
yep.
when he blocked yep. back for Slayton, it just opened him up. Loads of confidence.
We're talking about getting a chance to see Marcus Vick Saturday, too. Those 14-yard touchdown runs,
yes.
he's got some of that Vick burst.
Yes. And just as we show a nice little highlight package of it, he fumbles a football.
The last four Mountaineer possessions have all but one started in Yukon territory, and this one is a yard away from midfield. 35, 20, and 14-yard line of the Huskies, and this time from their own 49, but back on the loss of four.
You know, you made an interesting observation a few series ago. You talked about there are not a lot of blue-chip guys in this program in terms of high nationally acclaimed guys, but they're football players at West Virginia.
Just have to sniff them out a little bit differently than your Miamis, your Florida States. James Hargrave up for the stop here. But Rich Rodriguez manages and manages very well. You have really in this class 25 freshmen from 13 different states. I've never seen that wide a distribution of recruits ever by anybody.
I think it tells you, it shows you the appeal that Rodriguez has when he sits down with somebody.
Just overthrown. The target was Darrell Jallo, another redshirt freshman. Holly, one thing that Rich Rodriguez asks his veterans when they host recruits on campus is, will they fit in? Not just are they good athletes, but personality-wise, are they going to fit?
Dave, that's right. Actually, he has guys after the kids leave campus and they've hosted these recruits. He's like, okay, what do you think? Are they going to fit our program? And he really does a lot of research on it. He said, we get a certain type of kid here.
Waiting for Phil Brady to kick it away. Try and pin the UConn Huskies back somewhere inside their 15. Brandon McLean. 4 yards, returning a 42-yard punt. All Mountaineers, 5:55 to go in the half. UConn team 2 wins away from bowl eligibility, coming off a 9-win Motor City Bowl victory. But staring in the face now, 3-game losing streak. Dennis Brown, draw play, calling. Fights hard just to get back to the line of scrimmage. And they have really hurt their own cause. As if they needed to help West Virginia much tonight. They started their last 5 drives from their own 16, 19, 22, 10, and 15. Turned it over a couple of times. They have 0 rushing yards now on 14 carries. And all 52 of their yards on 6 of 11 from their freshman quarterback, Dennis Brown. Back to Cauley, same thing happens. From down 17 with 9 minutes to go in regulation, Brown. Going deep back at that Louisville game. If West Virginia goes on to have the season that they now have set up in front of them, it's not going to be hard to trace the turning point, the tipping point, as Allen carries. You're down 17 with 9 minutes to go. You got folks leaving, and then they find out as they're driving home on the car radio what they miss. Incredible turnaround. If they lose that game, Louisville's just fine. Everybody's got a loss in the Big East. Everybody figured this is going to be a conference that Louisville could march in and take over. Rich Rodriguez and his club picked mostly in the middle of the pack this year, even though they're coming off back-to-back co-Big East championships. And the first time they meet in the Big East, for West Virginia to get a win like that and show up defensively again as they have tonight. Eric Wicks joining Bobby Hathaway to sack Dennis Brown. All this from the 9-minute mark of the fourth quarter of that Louisville game. And if they go on and finish 11-1, which they could, they'll look at that as where their season really came together.
It was the beginning. And you know, on the flip side of success, watch these guys, that offensive line. They're just not moving. They're all bunched up. I mean, there's a football field out there that's pretty darn wide, and West Virginia's playing it. They're covering it. And Connecticut's offensive line is not getting it done, and the running backs behind them are playing as inept as the offensive line.
Fourth sack of the night. Incomplete. Intended for Brockington. And as they continue to tee off on Dennis Brown, you better get used to more of this.
Yeah, here's that word, inept. Brockington in the backfield, they're just not playing well. He's got to catch the ball. The ball's well thrown. They're in the flat, and it's just no execution. So you cannot blame this total collapse on Dennis Brown.
Mark Magro with the hit that knocked him backwards that time. So another Hussar punt, and it's blocked. That is going to turn into maybe his best punt of the night.
Yeah, absolutely.
What does that say? He's had some 25-yarders, but this blocked punt is finally down at the 37-yard line.
Let's see here.
Charles Pugh gets a good piece of that thing, and it goes straight up the field of the 37. First and 10. With 3:07 still remaining for the Mountaineers to add to this lead. The carry by Steve Slayton. We have Reese Davis and company waiting for halftime. Reese.
All right, guys, Mark May alongside coming up at halftime. We'll talk about the undefeated five, see if any has a chance to go down this weekend. Of course, Miami going to take on Virginia Tech, and we'll also have the latest on T.O.'s injury.
You're seeing some great defense tonight out of West Virginia, but at halftime, I'm going to tell you about the number one scoring defense in the nation.
It's going to be a big showdown in Blacksburg on Saturday, guys. We'll go ahead and start looking ahead.
Yeah, you can't talk too much about a matchup like Miami and Virginia Tech coming up. Slayton, close to the first. Right at it, should have it. Dana Deliston finally brings him down at the 47.
Yeah, I think Mark May's on to something. When you start talking about who's the, you know, that the last undefeated five and the top scoring defenses, that wise one May, he's on to something. Got to be able to stop him from scoring.
And as we talk about how highly ranked both those defenses are, watch. It'll be 46-44. Sure as you know, man.
Yeah, you know. All that pressure.
Blacksburg will be.
I just am not sold on Kyle. And, you know, Kyle Wright might become a really good quarterback. For instance, standing on the sidelines watching him play his first game there at Florida State, Drew Weatherford, you could see progress being made. And now we see Drew Weatherford, and Weatherford's a heck of a quarterback. I think they found their guy at Florida State.
Spurred ready to go nuts Saturday night. And another first down for Steve Slayton. Coming off 188 yards, 6 touchdowns. It took Butler and Deliston to bring him down here. Another first down Mountaineers with apparently time to spare with a minute 35 and 2 timeouts to work with from the 41-yard line of UConn. 16 carries for 71 yards and a touchdown tonight for Slayton, the true freshman from Levittown, Pennsylvania. One of the better stops by the UConn rush defense here. Dan Davis, defensive end. Sophomore out of Plainfield, New Jersey, who has missed a couple of games because of an ankle ligament problem, but good to go from the first snap tonight.
It seems like UConn's defense has the ability from time to time to make the stop, but it's a consistent basis that they're lacking right now.
First 10 plays, remember, for West Virginia, 5 for positive yardage, 5 for negative yardage. No, this is going to be for negative 1. White runs right into Raymond Fuller, the defensive tackle. And you're right, Craig. They intermittently shown the signs of being the high-ranked defense that they are, number six statistically overall in the country.
But for instance, you know, can you get them off the field? Third down, whatever the distance. Do you have a play or playmaker out there who can stop the opponent? And they don't do that consistently.
West Virginia will call its second timeout with 29 seconds here. UConn opened the season with back-to-back shutouts. Shutout teams they should have blown out and did, Buffalo and Liberty. And still averaging, allowing just under 15 points per game. So they're not at all accustomed to looking up and seeing the scoreboard like this. The rest of the way, West Virginia, which is well on its way to going 7-1, will go next Wednesday night here on ESPN2 to Cincinnati and take on the Bearcats. And then they've got Pittsburgh in the backyard brawl. And that reschedule game that was postponed because of the hurricane will be at South Florida December 3rd.
That's going to be a tough game. South Florida's a talented football team. And look at Rutgers, man. Way to go, Rutgers. Absolutely good team.
Bowl eligible after just 27 years.
What is it? Since the last time they went was 1978.
To a bowl that has not been in existence for about all of those 27 years. The Garden State Bowl, remember that? At the Meadowlands?
Yeah.
Somebody thought it was a good idea to bring teams up to East Rutherford in December. White airs this out and finds a target in single coverage, Brandon Myles, but incomplete at the goal line.
Myles on the outside, basically just your mini Hail Mary. Throw it down the field, see if Myles can come up with a play. Connecticut, nice job of Butler coming back inside, swatting the ball down, but they stopped him. You know what? I'm sitting there a while ago, and I was wondering, can they get him off the field? They stop him on third and long.
So Brady, who has been a big part of the huge difference in average starting position, that was waiting to be knocked down and killed at the two, and Antonio Lewis almost does it.
Well, I just, you know what, I really think this is such a neat idea with this coaching staff, the way they roll these guys out and punt the ball.
Rugby style.
That old rugby deal. Way to coach him up, Rich.
Brady talks about how challenging it is to be a punter for Rich Rodriguez. You can't just work on your power 45 or 50 yarder every day. You work on that, but you also work on the rollout and the angle and the high 30-35 yarder that's going to be fair caught.
Yep.
Randy Edsel's got more than enough to work on at halftime, trailing 35-3 here in Morgantown.